We're at the home of the Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up with the Cleveland Browns. Former Eagle has it teed up, and we are underway from Philadelphia. Taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive, almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. Picked off by Denzel Ward. And they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line.
At the 42-yard line.
Interception, Mayfield. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
Chubb will have the first down and much more. And all the way in, touchdown, Cleveland. Nick Chubb, 42 yards, and the Browns have taken the early lead.
Earlier in the week when they had their scouting report meeting, this was the explosiveness that they talked about trying to contain. They were concerned about it all week, yet he still did it to them. Wonder how that's going to carry over the rest of the game.
Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll get to the 30-yard line before going out of bounds.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Not the start that they were hoping for. The interception on the first play of the game, it leads to 6 points the other way. How do you rebound from here?
Yeah, a little bit of humor. You gotta laugh that one off, and not the ha-ha, that was very funny, but kind of like, can you believe that just happened? Let's go out and play now. Let's just start over.
It's a pickup of six.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're gonna open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
From the 35, back to work on second and four. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
In any event, it happened pretty quickly. I'm not sure he made the right decision on that one. I think if he had it to do over again, he would have found a different target downfield. But he made his decision, and that one's incomplete.
Being chased out left. He can run for it, and he will. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. The decision to tuck and run gets him three, but that's not enough. Now it's fourth. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They do go for it. It's Wentz. And Jeffrey's got it. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down.
First and 10 at the 50-yard line.
From midfield, here's Wentz. And that's complete to Jeffrey. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
How about a guy proving his worth in different ways? Had the big play in the run game to play before. This time, they go right back to him in the passing game, and he comes through with yet another big play. That's why you work out so hard in the offseason.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Zach Ertz, 27 yards. And the Eagles are within an extra point of tying this thing up.
And what a weapon he is at the tight end spot, because when they throw him the football downfield, they count on him getting additional yardage almost every time. And that's exactly what he did there. Caught that, ran with it, all the way to the end zone.
Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves them with a 2nd and 3.
Brings up 2nd and 3 at the 32-yard line.
A give. This is Chubb. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
12 more yards there and another first down. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 46. Mayfield finding Beckham, and he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 10 more there and another first down.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. On the ground, it's Chubb. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
He was brought down at the 28-yard line. It's a gain of 8. Brings up 2nd and 2.
They go with Chubb on 2nd down. And only 1 yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26.
Nate Gary on the tackle. It's a gain of 1 yard.
On 3rd down, it's Nick Chubb. And he's got some space here. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. Nick Chubb with his 2nd touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Browns have taken the lead. And a pair of rushing touchdowns now for him in the 1st quarter.
And I'm liking what I'm seeing from his big guys up front, because they're winning the leverage game. How many times have we talked about low man wins, right? Move the defensive front aside, create those gaps and holes. He's found his way through them for 2 touchdowns.
And after both of those touchdowns, he went right up to that O-line and hit each of them on the helmet. That's, he recognized
that's a smart man. You know what else he should do? If this continues, take them all to dinner.
Their own 16-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
And force the incompletion on 1st down, then you're able to shut down the running play on 2nd.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
On 3rd down. Oh, he almost had the rare interception. The big fella couldn't hang on, though. Incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a 4th down. Well done.
This offense converted once already in this first quarter. They're going to try it again here on fourth down. Here we go on fourth down with Wentz. And this is going to be incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And boy, possession here turns over with the football already being in the red zone. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. And again this time to the tailback. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. The Pro Bowler Fletcher Cox there to get him down.
A gain of a yard.
On second and 9, Mayfield. And he's got his tight end. It's Hooper for the Browns touchdown.
81, Austin Hooper.
Austin Hooper there to make the grab. And the Browns add 6 to their lead.
The kick is
and he'll bang that one through.
Makes the score Browns 21, Eagles 7.
Now after the score, it's Parkey on to kick it away. Taken in the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the...
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
Carson
Miles Garrett able to run him down for a loss of 12 that time. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Now second quarter action from Philadelphia, and it's the Eagles in possession as they've got it with a second down coming up. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And they'll get him down here. The 23.
Complete to Miles Sanders. A gain of 10 brings up third and 11.
It looks like a nickel set now for the Browns on third down. Shotgun now for Wentz. Steps away to his left. Looking deep for his tight end, Ertz. Incomplete. Both players were there offensively and defensively, but it falls incomplete.
Results in a fourth down.
It's going to stay out there. They've converted once, failed once. What can they do here on fourth down? They'll try and throw for it here. Deep ball for Goodwin. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward.
And that's now the second time he's picked off a pass here in the first half alone. Again, another great read defensively. And you just see him get in the right position to make the play and get his guys the football back.
The Browns drive about to get started. The ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown.
Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. The sack there by Brandon Graham coming in and bringing him down to the ground. Now following the sack, they'll come up here on a second down and 12. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. After getting stuck on first down, not much better there. 2 yard gain.
Sometimes your crosses get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first two plays. Didn't amount to much.
And now into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Avante Maddox. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. So after the INT, here's Wentz. He's going to let this go deep for Jackson. And incomplete, an excellent play downfield. Should have been picked off, really. But second down instead. Wentz on the give to Sanders. And he'll push forward for about four up to the 23.
Miles Sanders.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had the incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
From the gun on third down, Wentz. On Wentz is intercepted yet again. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20. Hey, this is just crazy. He's got three interceptions, Charles, and we haven't even departed the first half of this ball game.
I think if you're looking at the stats right now, you're saying, all right, who's the leading receiver? Well, can you flip it around and say that maybe he is and could be for the game the way that they...
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. Baker Mayfield with a touchdown pass to Austin Hooper. And the Browns add on to their lead. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Now this will make it into the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They're down three touchdowns to this point, needing to put something together as they have it first and 10. Now on first down, Sanders not finding a whole lot as he'll get forward for about three.
The ball carrier.
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last two drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
The quick feet by Jackson, and he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. A gain of 13, it's a first down. Well, CD, you know, taking a step back, we're 2 weeks into the season, and you already kind of get the sense that teams are beginning to separate themselves. If you look at the 2-0 teams, and remember, 62% of 2-0 teams ultimately make the playoffs. The Baltimore, Kansas City, Green Bay, Seattle, just to name a few, they look really good.
They certainly do, and in a lot of ways, those are the teams that we expected to be 2-0 at this part of the season. I mean, it's no major surprise. But how about Arizona being 2-0 as well? People talked about them getting better in the offseason. I don't know how many of us thought they'd beat San Francisco in the opener. They did. Then they jumped on Washington this week, and they are 2-0 as well.
Now, on the other side of the spectrum, we know the not good news about teams that start 0-2. The Giants and the Jets both there. Detroit, Cincinnati. So, again, maybe some more predictable names.
Certainly, they are predictable. Again, not a surprise for most of them, although many thought Detroit would be improved at this point. But how about a team that's 0-2 that went through a little bit of a difficult offseason like the rest of us, but even more so because of players being gone? How about Houston being 0-2 right now? They won the division last year. I think that's a little bit unexpected right now, even though they had a tough opening schedule with Kansas City and Baltimore.
So a 1st and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now, right at the 40. Again, it's Wentz. Looking deep for his tight end, Ertz. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their 4th pick of the game. Instead, 2nd down.
Thus far, they have been able to move the line of scrimmage very well in the running game. Almost felt like they said in the huddle, can you guys pass protect? Let's take a big shot downfield. Didn't get it on that one, but they may come back to it again.
This pass complete, wins to Ertz. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 22 yards there, a 1st down. 18-yard line. So from inside the 20, here's 1st and 10 at the 18. From the red zone now, Wentz. Now they go screen, it's complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. An 18-yard touchdown grab. And the Eagles make some inroads here on that deficit. There are several elements to a well-executed screen pass. This one resulted in a touchdown. It had all of those elements.
Hey, you're so right, because you really need to rush. You almost get to the quarterback, almost get to the passer. Then you got to get the ball thrown perfectly, whether it's to the running back, the wide receiver, whoever the screen guy is. And, of course, the blocking has to form in front to get him downfield for the touchdown.
Their own 25-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
A reminder coming up here at halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. Now Chubb. And he'll get this one up to the 26. The Eagles going to take the 1st of their timeouts. It's just their 1st, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Down Mayfield, and that will be incomplete.
That might be the 3rd down stop that they needed, because they've got a lot of trouble slowing down this offense in the 1st half. This might be their opportunity to get off the field.
On 4th down, here's Jamie Gillen on to punt. He'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline. And out of bounds, this will depend on where they spot it, and they'll say at the 45.
At their own 45-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They come in off a touchdown drive the last time they had the ball to cut down that lead. Now the defense has done their part, got them the football back.
Momentum started to shift a little bit when they scored the touchdown. It increased when the defense got them the ball back. Momentum definitely in their favor. Now they got to keep things cranking, keep it on high, so they can keep cutting into that lead.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. From the gun, it's Wentz. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. Working from the gun, Wentz. Open man, it's Rager. He's got it. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. 23 yards on the play. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Again, they'll throw with Wentz. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 30. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. Well, let's go back to the start of the season talk, Charles. We talked about some 2-0 and 0-2 teams. You mentioned Arizona, maybe a good surprise. Houston, a bad surprise. Any other teams a surprise at this point to you?
Well, I think that I would look at the Los Angeles Rams right out of the gate. At home against Dallas, opening their new stadium, many thought Dallas would go out west and beat them. That didn't happen. Then how about the Rams going on the road this week and beating Philadelphia and decisively? This looks like a Rams team that finished 9-7 last year. It has designs on challenging for the division title. And one other team I would throw in there is a little bit of a surprise, just by how it's gone down. How about Atlanta?
And he's in. Touchdown, Browns.
Touchdown.
Nick Chubb on his way to a monster game. 3 first-half touchdowns. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage.
That score that they just gave up there, that's a tough one for their defense to swallow because they've had a tough time through the first two quarters. They really were determined to get a stop there. Unable to do so, that makes their comeback hopes that much more difficult.
And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
At their own 26-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And you're under a minute to go in the half, a first half that hasn't been particularly kind to you. How do you think they'll play this?
Well, I think the smart approach is to run out the clock, lick your wounds at the half, and see if you can come up with a strategy to play better in the second. But there's also something to challenging your offense right here. You know, hey, guys, you help dig this hole. See if you can get us out of it a little bit before the half runs out. Let's go make some plays.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Denzel Ward right there in coverage to get the hand in.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about, and you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
And a diving grab. I think he got that. Yes. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. Wentz now on first down. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete. I hate to sound really negative, but at this point, an incomplete pass, almost a moral victory that it's not picked off.
Well, you may hate to sound negative, but that was negative.
It was very negative, I know. But all these first-half interceptions, it's been tough to watch.
Yeah, couldn't find a silver lining in this one. Much more like lead.
Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Here comes Sanders on the toss right. And he's down right around midfield after a gain of two, maybe three. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He's going to let this go deep for Jackson. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. By the Browns.
they'll take over first and 10 at their own 14-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, or they can even run a screen. You know, something they feel is somewhat safe that might actually pop and turn into a big play. That's what you usually run in this situation.
Or go four verticals because why not?
Because you're feeling it, right? You're just feeling it.
He was looking for Odell Beckham that time, but it's going to be second down. Here's second and 10. Final play of the half. Mayfield going deep here for Landry. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Kickoff for Philadelphia.
The Browns are going to get the second half kickoff, and they've got this lead as well as we are back and underway. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Browns drive about to get started. They had a big first half. Now they have a chance to add to that lead here in the opening possession of the second half.
And everyone always asks about halftime adjustments, kind of the key phrase. What did you do at halftime? Well, the way they ran offense in the first half, I think they were very calm, congratulatory. But also what they were saying is, don't expect them to be the same on defense. They'll be the ones making the adjustments. Let's see what they do, and we'll attack accordingly.
And we'll see how they attack here. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. 7 yards there and a first down. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Mayfield now. It's caught by OBJ. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. A gain of 6 there on first.
Brings up second.
Looking to throw again on second down. Mayfield, he'll let it go deep for Beckham. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. Pretty much everything went their way offensively in the first half, but now an interception on the opening drive of the third quarter.
As we know, the key to everything here, don't get careless with the football. The problem is you've got to stay aggressive as well. So where's the line between being aggressive and attacking and being overly aggressive? I think they just crossed it on that one.
Gain on the play brings up second and 10 at the 27-yard line.
Now Wentz throwing on second down. That'll be caught by Rodgers.
Wentz is past.
Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
Okay, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Goodwin able to haul it in. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. That's the first catch of the game for Goodwin. It's a first down.
First and 10 at the 48-yard line.
Wentz now on first down. That'll be caught. Rager with it. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That one goes for 24 yards.
That's another Eagles first down. First and 10.
Throwing on first is Wentz. Eluding the pressure right. This ball complete to Rager. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. Another first down as he went right back to the same well, this time for 17 yards. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Denzel Ward. And they'll have the football, but deep in their own territory as he's brought down at the 5. And give him now 4 interceptions in this game. That's only the third time this has been done since the year 2000.
I think that tells you how much better teams have gotten at throwing the football. Because if you go all the way back to 1960, 12 times before that, there have been guys who've gotten 4 interceptions or more in a game. I mean, most recently since 2000, Delta O'Neal and D'Angelo Hall.
And he will finally go out of bounds just shy of the 40.
4 yards.
And you hear it all the time, but that's one of the dangers of the blitz. You get past that first wave, nobody else is there.
And when teams blitz, what they're trying to do is make you lose your poise, lose your timing and your tempo. But when you hold it together, you can really hurt them the other way, getting past that first wave.
Looks like they went for the combo play there. A nice ample gain on the ground on the previous play. Going for the big shot on that one, unsuccessfully.
He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he is finally taken down, but not before he gets it to the Eagles 11. A gain there of 30 big ones.
This has been a good drive so far, and it's been the running game for the most part that's powered them down there. Another nice burst there, picking up a first down. Now it's first and 10, as you said, in the red zone.
They run again on first down, Chubb. They'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3. It's second and 7 from the 9. Hand off comes to Chubb. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland.
Touchdown.
A 9-yard touchdown run. And the Browns add 6 to their lead. And that rushing touchdown is 4th, puts him just 1 shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it. But he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he? What a performance. What an absolute great game that he's had here in this one.
And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. They're already at the line. This Philly offense set to go. And here we are almost through 3 quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that's quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Right back to Sanders on first down. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for an Eagle first down. 3 tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. Now Sanders. And he's going to take this across the 50 into Browns territory. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
It's a 2nd down run with Sanders. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 11 yards there, first down.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Boston Scott, his first carry. And he will be taken down, but a big pickup there on what's going to be the final play of the 3rd quarter. Thank you.
responsible without your money, I'm not. Thought he had a plan, but we go foil his plots. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hand on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money, I'm not. Thought he had a plan, but we go foil his plots. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hand on the clock.
Come like a bat out of the hell, I dare you to cross like a reverend. And my energy paralyzed, I'm like a finger 11. Take a second, I'm finna send it like a parent. A message to the best. If it ain't me, then you need you a confession. You a mess. You ain't scary to me. Heard you was a leader, but that ain't apparent to me. Put dust on you, Vegeta, run up and I'm airing the scene. I feel just like Vegeta Prince, and I'm an heir to the seat.
I mean, for real. Tesla driving soft, so I don't even grab the wheel. That's on my chest, but it don't mean the man is stealing. Man, I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Ew, think you need a mail. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field. That's why I'm always cheesing, cause I feel like Uncle Phil. And all this loose thing, the first, but ain't happy, man, as well. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plots. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hand on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Plus.